Check. 1, 2. Check. Please stand by for a very special episode of Pack a Day, featuring our first ever special guest presenter.
What's up, baseball nerds? Glad to see you back for another episode of Pack a Day. We have another pack of 89 tops. That box is getting pretty thin. We've got a few packs left. We're gonna rip into this guy and see who we get. All right? Okay. First card. All-Star Series. The Wizard. Ozzie Smith. What do you say about Ozzie? He's in the Hall of Fame. 13 consecutive gold gloves. Which, interestingly enough, he sold at auction after retiring. Is he the greatest defensive shortstop of all time? I say flip a coin between Omar Vizquel and him. So here's the next question then. If Ozzie's in the hall, shouldn't Vizquel be there as well? Food for thought. Ha! What do you know? Another light-hitting, sure-handed shortstop named Ozzie. But this one can't seem to keep his mouth shut, and I doubt he could ever do a backflip. Ozzie Guillen, he did win the Rookie of the Year in 85? Yep, 85. Daryl Boston, outfielder. I think he's the White Sox first base coach now, but I think with Renteria getting fired, that may all change soon if it hasn't already.
We have a future star alert, ladies and gentlemen. Future star alert. Sandy Alomar,
your 1990 AL Rookie of the Year and Gold Glove winner. So he obviously established himself as a premier defensive catcher from the start. He played for 20 years, I bet, and then he went into coaching. Most recently this year, he filled in as the manager of the Indians while Francona was out with illness. Here's a... Mr. Rob Ducey, outfielder. And check it out. If you didn't notice by my shirt, I am a Cubs fan. And what you've got here is the Cubs leader card, prominently featuring Mr. Greg Maddux. Got GOAT status alert here. So we got his regular series card a few days ago. Now we've got the All-Star Series card for Bobby. Still smiling because he's thinking about that sweet, sweet Mets paycheck he'll be cashing. But in 88, he was an All-Star for the Pirates, and he was driving in 100 RBI along with teammates like Andy Van Slyke, I'd say, was on that team. Bonds. Was Bonds still on the team? Yeah, Bonds was still with him. So, that was a pretty solid offense. Mike Greenwell, the Gator, I think was his nickname. So, Mike here played left field for Boston. He was kind of dealt a tough hand from the get-go. He had some really big shoes to fill. You got to keep in mind, the three previous left fielders for the Red Sox had been Ted Williams, Yaz, and Jim Rice. So Greenwell did have a great season in 88. If it hadn't been for that insane season that Canseco had, Greenwell would have won the MVP in 88 for the American League. But as life goes, Greenwell didn't live up to the hype of Williams and Yaz and Rice, but he did have a pretty decent major league career. Oh boy. So here's the card, or one of the cards I've been waiting on that isn't a Hall of Fame rookie card. This is Eddie Lee Whitson. I'm going to introduce our first ever special presenter here for Pack a Day. This is Commissioner of the Eddie Whitson Love Child Rotisserie League, and he is the true living authority on Ed himself, Mr. Todd Akers.
Todd, my man, take it away.
Okay, Adam, this is like take number 14, so I'm not doing it anymore. You're going to have to edit the daylights out of this video, okay?
Yeah. Sorry, brother. I'm not going to edit this thing at all.
I'll do the best I can, but good luck, pal. Hi there. I'm Todd. I want to first of all thank Adam for letting me help him with his pack a day. He has graciously asked me to talk about Ed Whitson. And so I'm more than happy to do so. First, a few facts about Ed. He made his major league debut with the Pittsburgh Pirates in 1977 and was a major contributor to the Pirates World Series team of 1979 by getting traded mid-season to the Giants for Bill Madlock. So he was a very big help for the Pirates. Whitson is probably most well known for his role in the massive bean brawl war between the Pirates and the Braves in 1984. Just to kind of let you know how that went, the Braves pitcher Pascual Perez hit the Padres' leadoff batter with the very first pitch of the game. Dick Williams was the Padres' manager, and he asked Whitson to hit Perez the next time he came up to bat. This happened in the second inning. But Whitson tried and missed three times. So the umpires warned both benches about what was going on. And when Perez came back up to bat again in the fourth inning, Whitson tried to make good on his promise. And so he tried and missed three times again to hit Perez. This, however, started the first of many massive brawls that happened during this game. This is the point of time when Adam is going to start showing some of that wonderful bean brawl footage.
For the fourth straight time, Perez coming to the plate. We've got one going now. And there are some hot-tempered individuals out there. Pascual Perez not involved there. Well, I tell you what. It's about as good a little battle as you're going to see. We've got about five separate fights going on out in the field. Pascual Perez is not out there. He's gone back to the Atlanta dugout. Champ Summers went after Pascual Perez, while all the other players congregated out in the middle of the infield. Summers headed directly for the Braves dugout. He was held back by somebody. Here he goes. Summers charging after Perez. Bob Horner has come out. We've got some fans involved now. Oh, my. Oh, my. This one is very close to getting totally out of control. A couple of fans have come down onto the field. Other fans were involved throwing things. There's still one fan down there in the middle of all that. Okay, we've got one fan that's been grabbed by a couple of security guards. There we go again. Now Gerald Perry and Tim Flannery getting into it. Or is that Bavacqua? Flannery's been pulled out of that rhubarb. We've had about six or seven separate fights break out here. Security guards down in the field have a couple of fans in handcuffs leading them off the field. Flannery's been pulled back by Joe Pignatano. It's not so funny anymore.
A couple of fans have been handcuffed. They're being let off. I wonder if Horner re-injured his hand. He was trying to prevent it down in front of the Atlanta dugout. John McSherry now right in the middle of it, and he's saying, "Get everybody, get back where they belong."
The umpiring crew trying to get Tepper's cool down. I am amazed, really.
At one point, Whitson was in the clubhouse getting dressed, and he came back out into the dugout with no shirt to join into another fight.
Another thing you've done in the ninth inning.
That's Ed Whitson. He was the first guy to go during all this.
Bob Horner, who played for the Braves, was on the disabled list, and he came down from the press box into the clubhouse to get dressed in his uniform so he could go on the field and participate in the fights.
Okay, we've got the word now on the players who... And that pitch hits Greg Nettles, and he's going after Donnie Moore. Here we go again. Nettles in the middle, Moore backing out. The benches are emptying again. My, oh my, oh my. Is thrown out. Goose Gossage going after Donnie Moore. They're heading toward the Braves dugout again. Here goes Greg Nettles after Moore, and he was really tackled in front of that Braves dugout. At the bottom of all that, Joe Torre pulling Alan Wiggins away. Steve Bedrosian, who's been thrown out of the game, is out in the field. And we got another one breaking out. Another one is breaking out. Gene Garber pulling Tim Flannery away from somebody. Yet another fight is broken out. Out in front of the dugout, a couple of the Braves players who have been ejected, Rick Mailer and Steve Bedrosian, are both out in the field. So is Gerald Perry. That could get them in some more trouble. We've got more trouble breaking out. The Padres and some fans are getting into it. Over by the Padre dugout, the umpires and the security guards head over that way to try to fend off any problems over there. Now a fan is trying to steal a batting helmet, and he's going to get leveled. Jerry Royster just tackled a fan over by third base. Padres are coming out again. A fan tried to come down on the field and run off with a batting helmet. Ed Whitson trying to get back out on the field. Norm Sherry, Harry Dunlop restraining him. Yet another fan being walked off the field by security.
It was crazy. Their fans got involved. Perez was swinging a bat. A lot of people got tossed in this game. 17 total, I think, players and coaches. It was the most in Major League history at the time. The umpires even went so far as to clear the benches and send all the players back to their clubhouse, except for the ones that were actively participating in the game at the time. So crazy stuff. This, however, wasn't Whitson's last brush with pugilistic fame. Later on in his career, when he played for the Yankees, he had gotten a fight with Billy Martin, who's the Yankees manager, in the hotel bar, of course. Where else are you going to find Billy Martin? It was a really nasty brawl. Most of the Yankees had to come down from their rooms to stop the fight. They tried to break it up. They got the players and the coach out into the street where the fight continued. Billy Martin wound up breaking his arm, and Whitson had a couple of broken ribs. It was pretty terrible. And what ended up happening was at the end of the year, Billy Martin got fired by George Steinbrenner for his penchant for getting drunk and starting fights, I guess. This made Whitson public enemy number one in New York. And so for the following season, Whitson couldn't pitch any games at home because of how horribly he was treated. So he made every start for the Yankees that next year on the road until he was traded back to the Padres. Ed Whitson was also the Game 3 winner of the 1984 National League Championship Series against the Cubs. Karma spoke up when Whitson started Game 2 of the World Series. Whitson didn't make it out of the first inning. He got bombed. Only got two outs and was pulled. So that's what happens when you mess with God's favorite baseball team. That's what happens when you mess with God's favorite baseball team. So why is Ed Whitson so important, you may ask? Well, I'll tell you. In the spring of 1990, a young sweet boy named Brennan McGeehee asked 12 of his friends to cram into his dorm room and start a fantasy baseball league. And on that day, we did. And the number one overall pick was none other than our hero, Ed Whitson. Why was Ed picked first? Because the person who drafted him, nominated him, was an idiot. But that's okay, because Ed Whitson has become our namesake. And the Ed Whitson Love Child Rotisserie League has been going strong for 30 years, of which Adam has been a part of. Thank you, Adam. And with that, I'm going to leave you. Because this is on the internet, there is a non-zero chance that Ed Whitson is actually watching this right now. So I would like to ask you, Mr. Whitson, if you would ever like to join us for a draft weekend. We'll give you all the food, all the beer you can drink. It's on us. We'll even have the draft in your home state of Tennessee, if you so desire. And so, as I bid you adieu, let me show you the shirt I have commemorating that 1984 Bean Brawl. And now we'll give it back to Adam.
All right. Thanks, Todd. I appreciate you taking the time to put together such an incredibly detailed presentation on Mr. Eddie Lee Whitson. Ed, if you're out there, you heard Todd's invitation. We'd love to have you at one of our drafts, okay? Getting back to the action here. We've got Ivan the Terrible. Ivan Calderon. He's strung together a few good years with the Shy Sox, I think. Kind of a 2020 type. But I want to say he was murdered, right? Was Ivan the gentleman that was murdered outside of a nightclub in Puerto Rico after he retired? Was he shot like 9 times or something? My apologies to Ivan. We got a double Maddox pack. Twice the goat in this one, guys. So Maddox obviously started out with the Cubs, and then he moved on to the Braves, where he did have his greatest seasons. Maddox in the Hall of Fame, 4 consecutive Cy Young Awards, 18 gold gloves. Only Warren Spahn has won more career victories than the professor in the live ball era, okay? He won 15-plus games for 16, I think, straight seasons. And he shares a birthday with former teammates Dave Justice and Steve Avery. In fact, I think he and Dave Justice were born on the exact same day, same year. Widely considered one of the greatest pitchers of all time, yet somehow he still comes across as underrated. And he has a wicked sense of humor. Rob Deere. So you remember the other night when we were talking about 3 true outcomes and Buehner? Yeah, this guy right here makes Buehner look like Tony Gwynn. Keith Moreland, Zonk. He spent some time between several teams, Phillies, Padres, Cubs, I think some others. He played all over the place, too. I want to say he was kind of like B.J. Scherhoff. He was every position on the field. Topps All-Star Rookie Series of my man, Mark Grace. So, Mark has the most hits and doubles in the 1990s and is a certified member of the Hall. Very good. He finished things out with 2,500 plus hits, a handful of gold gloves. He got that World Series ring with the D-backs in 2001. And he also was a real knucklehead there for a while, getting arrested for DUI more than once. But I think he's sober now, got his act together, and is doing some coaching again. So good for you, Mark. And the last card in this pack, Ruben Sierra. Journeyman over the course of probably 20 years, I'd say. He ended his career as another member of the Hall of Very Good, I think. He flashed power all over the place throughout his career. Solid hitter, I think. And that's it. It's all of our cards. I hope you enjoyed this. Again, Todd, thank you for taking your time for the Ed Whitson presentation. I could not have done that myself at all. Come on back. We'll open up another pack of 89 Tops. Maybe. Maybe something else. Depends on what kind of mood I'm in at this point. But at any rate, I hope everybody stays safe, stays happy. Remember to go and vote. All right? Later.
And I really can't do this again. It's driving me crazy. The battery died.